Hello?
Ben?
Amy.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise, good to see you.
Yeah, welcome to LifeLoop.
Is this the loop?
This is the loop.
Tell me about it. What do you guys do?
So we are a software that connects families to senior living communities.
Nice.
So we sell to the senior living community. They use it for a lot of operational things. Yeah. So for example, calendars, photos, transportation coordination, maintenance, you know, a lot of non-clinical operation stuff.
So how did you come up with this idea? Because this seems like something that came from an experience.
Yes. So our family, like a lot of families, have the experience of moving a loved one into a community. And my father-in-law had a mom that was living in independent living, quickly needed memory care. And that process kind of sparked the idea of, couldn't it be better for us to have a better conversation with staff, have a more meaningful conversation with her, and just bridge the gap between the three audiences.
So what brings you the most pride in what you've created, what you do?
You know, I think my team brings me the most pride first, because they're a group of passionate people that believe in what we're doing, and without that, you can't really take care of your customers.
Yeah.
So, and then our customers and connecting families. When you see families, seeing the benefits, really powerful. So,
can I see the app? Do you have an example that we can see?
Yeah, absolutely.
We're back here.
Yeah, come on in.
Is this where the magic happens?
This is where the magic happens.
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, let me show you a little bit about the product.
So it runs just on...
It runs
on
it runs on anything with internet. So Apple, Android, mobile, tablet. Let's say you're at movie night here. And this is currently something that the staff is doing on paper. So now you can just hit, you know, take attendance, and your residents are gonna pop up. And you can say Alexa attended, Amy attended.
Let's see. As a family member, then I can log in and I can see
real time.
Like, oh, grandma's watching Marvel.
So then more importantly, let's say Betty declines because she's not interested.
Right.
That's a big touch point for families, because they, a lot of times, they don't know what's going on during the day. They make up scenarios in their head. So
it just keeps the information updated.
Right.
So that it's always available for whoever wants to see it.
Right now, Alexa moves into a community. How do you, as a staff, get to know Alexa?
Right.
Right now, it's in a binder. You have people coming and going all the time from a turnover perspective. So this is a great way to see a face, get to know a little bit about them. So, you know, what did she do before she moved in? What is she like? What is she not like?
Yeah.
And then how can you search your whole population?
Oh, she's won a lot of money at Texas Hold'em.
She loves Texas Hold'em.
Yeah, that's
she's
good.
A big poker player.
Love it. You so can, how big are you guys? I mean, is this like just here in Omaha, or is this like?
We are in 28 states.
Okay.
So we've grown from being in one community to being in hundreds across the U.S.
So that's awesome.
28 states.
Is there like a place close by that we could go see it in action?
Yeah, we could go check out the Rose Blumpkin home.
Yeah. Can we go do that?
Yeah, let's go. Welcome to the Rose Blumpkin home. Well, there's Maggie. How are you? Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Yeah. This is Ben.
Hi.
Nice to meet you, Maggie.
Nice to meet you.
I was telling Ben that I wanted to introduce him to somebody that uses LifeLoop.
Yeah.
So here we are.
So you're an early adopter.
Oh, and just love it.
Yeah. How has it changed what you did before versus how you do it now?
We were like in the pioneer stage of one book, attendance book, with all four activity directions.
Like paper.
Paper.
Ooh.
Back in the Stone Age. So it's like I can't imagine our life without LifeLoop. It has increased our attendance by 30%,
has
and
it
I'm
really?
Being modest about it.
Yeah, so this is an example of one of the features that we've added on to the product, just because we saw the need from our user's perspective of not doing duplicate entries. So they're entering all this great data in LifeLoop, menus, activities.
Yeah, so we can see kind
announcements.
Of what's going on.
So that's being entered by the staff on the front end, but then it flows over to LifeLoop, to the display. And so this is a great example of how Rose Blumpkin's creating some efficiencies with their calendar.
I love hearing a success story like this, but I can't imagine it's been easy.
No.
So like what's some of the big challenges that you face in getting someone like Maggie?
Yeah. Well, I think on the front end it was hard for us to understand the true challenges. And I think one of the things that we overcame was kind of putting our ego aside and understanding that we might not know the real problems. So listening to people like Maggie and other folks that early came onto the product and said, no, this is actually what we need.
Yeah.
That was a challenge we overcame, and just trying to build something for a problem that has lots of different layers.
Right. So in being a small business owner,
mm-hmm.
what advice would you give to other small businesses to be successful like you have been?
Well, that's a great question. I think you have to be very flexible. You have to learn to adapt quickly. That's something that I think that we've done well as a team. The other thing is I think believing in your team and trusting your team to do the right thing is something I would recommend.
Well, congratulations on being Small Business of the Month.
Thank you. We really appreciate it. Thanks for everything.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Great to see you.
Okay.
And what else you got for us?
That's it.
You got a bus? Are we going somewhere?
We can go in.
Let's go to the zoo.
The zoo.
Let's go see those residents.
That's where everybody's at.